Hello guys, it's Hiroshi here and it is really good to be back after what seemed like a month because I just saw that my vendor this paddock just, you know, blew up into like almost 1,000 views as same as we were like opening 20 packs, something like Sky Tracker even got 3,000. Now I have to make other video on it. Okay, so this is gonna be like, you know, report on this month or something like that. So first we're going to the metagame report on week 5 and 6 on the OCG side because I'm on OCG of course. On the top deck, as you can see, it is still branded this pair and the decklist hasn't changed much. This is going to be the decklist that I will show you here. It won't be the copy paste, so you don't have to, you know, put in the card or just edit out something. And the second deck is Adventurer Tenji, which I have also make a video about. I mean, of course, all the video will be on top of the corner right here. And decklist is something, right, as you can see here. Nothing much changed, of course, because it is still the same deck, if not exactly the same. Yeah, and some tank cards got limited, like, you know, Sword Soul Emergency. I can't remember the name, the exact name, but that's out of the way. So next we have Yu-Gi-Oh! History Archive 01, or the first history archive of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Set. So basically this is going to be, you know, the anime-based card. Normally reprinting a lot of anime cards, yeah. Like, you know, the hero thing, the blue eye, the direction, something like that, but it goes all through the way, yeah, it goes all the way, yeah, from Kaiba to the newest, which is Yuma, I think Yuma or Yuling, yeah, something like that, with the Link, yeah, with the Code Talker. And what it gave us is a reprint of something like Magician Souls and SS Code Talker, which is, I think it's the best, oh no, the biggest reprint in the set here, yeah, because also thing is just going to be, you know, collectible, you know, the new Blue Eye art, the new Red Eye art, yeah, and the new Dark Magician Girl art, which is, you know, really good, yeah. I won't complain, and I also Blue Eye Alternative Dragon, because I mentioned 3 of these cards, because this 3 of these cards is really expensive in the OCG market, and of course in the TCG market as well. On the Magician Souls, you can get in as low as, you know, normal Paleo Lair is selling for, you know, $3 a copy, so you can get a playset for just $10, which is really bogger for, you know, Magician Souls. As I looking for the TCG price, which is $50, what, something around $40 to $50 a copy, so you need $100 to get a 3 off, which is, you know, blow my mind because of, you know, 10 times of the more expensive. But yeah, TCG player is on Europe and America and got, you know, bigger minimum wage because Save Thailand, we have only, you know, $10 of a minimum wage per day, not per hour, but I digress. Okay, and also SS Code Talker is now reprinted into normal parallel layer, which can be get for as low as, of course, $3 a copy. While in the TCG side, is around $40, which is, you know, really expensive here. And I mean, of course, you only need one anyway. And the last card is Blue Eye Alternative Dragon. I can't remember much, but it normally got reprint on the set that is about Kaiba. So it will be reprint on really expensive reality, really good reality, yeah, like Ultra Parallel, Secret Parallel, or Millennium Lair, or something like that. Yeah, for it's gonna be expensive. Then now it's just $3, $5 maximum for a copy for a lower playset. So making Blue Eye decks in real life might be easier now. And same with Blue Eye deck, and same with Pendulum Spiral that use the Magician Souls. Yeah, and overall deck because it used Asset Code every deck. Yeah. The next thing that we have is a Plight of the Week. If you don't know, Plight of the Week is a card that revolve around, you know, the name, yeah, I mean, the card doesn't matter, just the name. The Plight of the Week is, you know, a lot of weak beating round up, and it is an event in Thailand that using Master Duel to you make a deck that can only have 5 super lair in total and 1 outer lair. Nothing more than that. And of course, I participate as well. I use the Klee deck. I will show you the picture right here. It use, of course, 5 super lair and 1 outer lair. I mean, the idea might sound really weird, but when you start making it, it starts to feel kinda like, you know, cool and normal, and you know, now no meta will be on the way except, you know, True Draco, because the deck is pretty easy to make, yeah. And the winner is actually Megalith, yeah. The winner is actually Megalith Incantation 1000 Arm Maju, yeah. This is the deck list, and if you want to play, you know, Chancellor, yeah, wanna make a deck with only 5 super land and 1 other, you make this, which is what is it again? Megalith, yeah. And this is the Mega list, and I think that is all I have for you today. I will be making that a list soon on the, you know, meta game, yeah. Because I don't know much about Brighton. My friend played Brighton, of course, but I don't know about much about combo because you know, I kind of brain dead and start playing other card game nowadays. Like, you know, Magic the Gathering and Rune of Terra, Legend of Rune Terra. Yeah, not that fun, but it does what it does. And it, I just play it as, you know, the cheaper version of Magic the Gathering Online or Magic the Gathering Arena, because Magic Arena is just a gacha game. Yeah, we make the tier list, I think, I have it in my head, yeah, to make a tier list of the simulation of the card game tier list, yeah. So, expect that soon, I think, and yeah, that's gonna be not a short video, but kind of an update video, and news and things around the month, and yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Have a good one. Thank you.